Elimination Chamber.
What the hell is that?
An ingenious creation.
The Elimination
from the mind of Eric Bischoff. Six Raw Superstars.
The Elimination
for the
Chamber.
World Heavyweight title.
A Survivor Series. The Elimination Chamber.
The Elimination Chamber.
These men may never be the same.
Exercises that just anyone.
No, I think you're exactly right.
This is a freak thing, you know.
And of course, Kane, he's got to be ready for next Sunday at Survivor Series as well as Booker T. Two of the six men in the Elimination Chamber match. And we found out this past Monday night, it's going to show everybody a little bit later on, that we now know Lita all six superstars in that title match at Survivor Series.
HBK making number six, as I think everybody pretty much
figured that he would. Please. Yeah, exactly. You know what we just missed? We just missed the classic button bump. Well, now Stamboli, what power? He is so strong at power slam, but no cover.
A lot of aggression coming out.
Maybe I really did make him mad.
Right there.
You said that was a turn on for you?
Aggression coming out.
Oh, look at it.
I mean, cool, calm, and collected. That's one thing, but you got to know when to just.
I'm starting to see a side of you that I didn't know existed in, to be honest with you. I kind of like it.
Oh, there's Goldust. A lot you don't know about.
we'll get to that. Big elbow on the back of Goldust. Now Stamboli in control. Here's the cover. Hook to the leg. One, two. And Goldust is able to kick out.
I think Stamboli, Goldust aggravated him early on with a simple flip of the hat.
Sometimes you get kind of pumped out. Oh, hard. hard into the corner of Goldust.
Whether by a female or by Goldust.
It doesn't matter. You know, either way, here's another cover. 1-2, and again, easily getting the shoulder up is Goldust. You know, Lita, we were talking about before we came on the air the fact that this is a huge week here in the WWE, not only in Survivor Series next Sunday, but Lita, of course, this Tuesday, it's WWE
Super Tuesday!
9 o'clock, 8 Central on UPN, a special Survivor Series Super Tuesday show. Superstars from Raw, superstars from SmackDown.
Let's just get right to it, and two girls in bikini.
On interpromotional bikini challenge.
First ever interpromotional bikini match.
Well, I think you're more excited about it than I am. And that takes a lot. Oh, nice bridge. 1-2. Oh, and nearly a three count on Stamboli. But also an exclusive interview, Lita, with Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid, this Tuesday. 1-2. Oh, and getting the shoulder again is Goldust. 9 o'clock, 8 Central on UPN. But also this Tuesday on sale, WWE Anthology. It is the most anticipated release of music that WWE has ever had. A triple CD set, 86 great songs from all kinds of generations here in the WWE, from 20 years ago to today. And I think your song's on there, is it not? Are you on Anthology?
I'm on the promos. So I better be on there. Yeah, yeah, getting a cut of that Anthology.
Yeah, exactly. It's going to be a huge day this Tuesday, November 12th. And now Goldust reverses off. And now so much has been taken out of
Goldust. Stamboli may be in trouble now. He was on top of things for a while. Let's see if he can get back up and on top of Goldust.
And now referee Chad Patton with the 10 count. Both men struggling to get back to their feet. And now Goldust, we've known the role he's been on as of late, but Johnny Stamboli, a stiff challenge here tonight. Big sunbite. Stamboli right back up, balled up by another. And now Goldust whips Stamboli. Wait a second. Almost a reversal right to the midsection. Oh, nice DDT. And here's a cover by Goldust. No hook of the leg. 1-2. And Stamboli able to kick out. So this Stamboli, obviously, physically, he's always in great shape. But what do you think Lita's going to take? Oh, and now going for the shattered dreams. Oh, but Stamboli able to reverse
it. Able to counter.
Oh, look, just like that. Whips him over. Hook of the leg is maybe enough. Oh, but kick it out again. Stamboli, it seems like he's on the crust of becoming a big-time superstar, in my opinion. I don't know how you feel about it. I think you're just watching him. I think you just like watching his body.
I can't deny that.
Oh, shattered dream! I know you can't deny it! And we can't deny a Goldust victory! Well, a big victory for Goldust as we kick things off. Suspense is over. Raven reveals his masterpiece. Oh, I can't wait. Next.
MTV2 is music 24 hours a day, and at the end of the week, that means the wrap. Straight from the MTV newsroom, Gideon Yeago brings a unique look at the music and the mayhem of the moment.
Find out what this is all about.
From the biggest stars to the most oddball events, nothing is off limits as the highly opinionated Gideon reports on today's biggest stories. Catch the wrap Sundays at 9:30 p.m. Eastern, 6:30 Pacific, only on MTV2. If you don't get MTV2, call your local cable or satellite provider to find out how.
You're getting slammed with MTV's WWE Heat thanks to Burger King. Say hello to the new 99 cents BK value menu. And Sega.
Welcome to the kingdom.
Hey, what's up?
Jack.
How you doing?
Hey.
What's up?
Jack.
I gotta have an extreme bacon and cheese whopper.
You got it.
The original Whopper, America's favorite burger, just got extreme. For a limited time, get juicy flame-broiled beef, two kinds of cheese, and four strips of crispy bacon. You gotta have the extreme bacon and cheese Whopper at Burger King now.
Welcome to the kingdom, baby.
Rated M for mature.
Where is he?
Oh!
Shinobi's back!
Sega!
Justin Timberlake.
It's just Justin.
Justified. Justified from Justin Timberlake, the most anticipated album of the year. 13 new songs, including Rock Your Body, Cry Me a River, and the hot new hit, Like I Love You.
Keep looking like I do.
Justin Timberlake, Justified, in stores now.
Play a secret agent? Irresistible. I get to outsmart the bad guys and look disarmingly beautiful while doing it.
The limited edition 007 color collection, inspired by Bond, created by Revlon.
I still think it should be Berry. Halle Berry.
See Halle Berry as Jinx in Die Another Day. Enter for a chance to win a Ford Thunderbird.
And it's only from Revlon. Be unforgettable.
The hero. The adventure.
Spider-Man!
Woo! The DVD. With spider-rific experts like filmmakers' commentary.
Let mom and dad talk for a minute, will ya?
Spider-Man archives.
Who is Spider-Man?
And much more. Spider-Man.
We'll meet again, Spider-Man!
The number one movie of the year catches you in its web. Now on DVD and video. Rated PG-13.
Word of the unveiling of the masterpiece.
Raven has promised
is that tonight?
Time and time again, promise. This is the night.
This should no doubt be revolutionary. This will no doubt.
All our questions should be answered.
I hope so.
If you people would cease your mindless babbling, we can begin.
Is he talking to us?
For weeks now, in my personal playground, there's been inquisitive chattering regarding my masterpiece. Because we as humans are naturally curious. And you see, curiosity leads to temptation. And temptation leads to sin. And sin, that is what my masterpiece is all about.
I thought curiosity killed the cat.
He's killing me.
Now, for years, you people have looked at me like I'm a freak. You've called me immoral, and you've called me depraved. But as I look out amongst you people, I see a festering mass of hypocrisy.
What is that?
Who are you people to call me immoral?
I'm getting out my freaking East Dictionary. Hold on.
Yeah.
Why don't you take a good, long look at yourselves? Oh, that's right. You can't! Because you're too busy leading lives of quiet desperation without the courage to stand up to your own filthy convictions. And that is why I must complete my masterpiece. To bring salvation to your souls and to open eyes that are so blind to the truth. Quote the raven, nevermore.
You know, I knew this was going to happen.
What you got for me, Coach?
Well, Lita, a little bit later on, I knew this was going to happen. So I have brought an interpreter to Heat tonight, and we'll hear from that interpreter a little bit later on as to what Raven had to say. But coming up next on Heat, we'll take you back to last week's emotional episode of Tough Enough 3. That's next.
A sleeping giant.
I am 7 foot 500 pounds.
Has been awakened.
I am the biggest.
You can't manhandle the Big Show.
Fast.
And I don't think you can get him up for an F5.
Man in the universe.
You can't beat the Big Show.
You're gonna make a challenge.
You want a shot at my title? You got it.
Brock Lesnar, the Big Show, the WWE Champion.
Hey, I'll be right here waiting.
Raw and SmackDown present WWE Survivor Series, brought to you by Xbox Live, next Sunday on pay-per-view.
Thursday at 10, not all moves go down in the ring.
I really have a crush on John, and it's not going away.
And another one gets the axe.
Somebody's about to lose their dream.
Yeah. You getting this?
Oh, yeah!
On a remote mountain peak, six friends witnessed a group of terrorists planning the unthinkable.
We really need to get out of here.
Now, they've got 24 hours.
Just kill them.
To warn the world.
Someone doesn't want us to leave.
On November 27th.
Keep moving!
Never give up. Never give in. Extreme Odds. Rated PG-13. Starts Wednesday, November 27th.
Hey yo, part two, AI and J Kiss presenting the A6 from the wrist. Could tell us a straight switch. Now I'm the problem, and he's the answer. Soon as you try to guard up, you ain't got a chance to stop it. Any given time, he could pop it. The Reebok A6 is hot, go cop it. For 2K3, I rock the A6, my new kicks. Take a few hits, it ain't nothing, I'm used to it. Trying to build a team, I'm the player you need. Hot like Willis Reed, top thief and score in the lead. A zone, part two, AI and J Kiss presenting the A6. It's all fundamental and basics.
Get ready for Mario Party 4. Four players pair up in a battle royale of 50 mini-games.
Played at the corner of madness and mayhem. Only on Nintendo GameCube. Rated everyone.
What's the deal, y'all? This is Missy Misdemeanor Elliott. I'm here to tell y'all about my new album, Under Construction, featuring the number one hit single, Work It.
It's your primitive plan yet.
Under Construction, in stores November the 12th. You dig?
This holiday is a time for giving, for sharing, and for Adam Sandler. A on November 27th.
Oh, shut up!
Get ready for the ultimate battle between Naughty.
I tell you, your girlfriend's backyard isn't sugar-free. That baby looks sweet.
And Nice.
Shaving the chest.
Nobody needs a unibrow.
Oh, my God.
Adam Sandler's 8 Crazy Nights. Rated
PG-13.
In theaters everywhere, November 27th.
A lot of people are still hesitant to pick up the phone and give us a call. Now we've made it even easier. Just dial 1-800-MY-NEW-CAR. No salespeople, no operator, and no hassles. Answer all the questions completely, and you could be approved in as little as 15 minutes. It's that simple. So what are you waiting for? Call 1-800-MY-NEW-CAR. And with over 100 lending programs, if we can't get you a bank loan, no one can. 1-800-MY-NEW-CAR. Getting a car loan has never been easier.
What if what you thought was impossible suddenly wasn't? What if your cable company was working round the clock to change the way you watch TV forever? What if there was a cable company that actually cared about you? Now anything's possible. Time Warner Cable.
Now.
Thursday at 10:30.
Yeah. Barter College is in serious trouble. Applications are down 73%. Graduates cannot read above a fifth grade level.
I don't think your statistics reflect the quality of student on this campus.
What the hell is that?
I don't know.
Kill it!
All my freaks call me the big bad booty daddy. I only care about two things. My freaks and my peaks. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
Big Papa Pump is on his way.
Why are you yelling?
I hear him.
Whatever. Right now, we're going to take you back to last week's episode of Tough Enough 3.
How's that finger doing?
What's up?
You really did hurt that finger, huh? Did you break it?
Torn ligament.
Are you serious?
Even if my hand does hurt tomorrow, I'm still going to go through it, and I'm not going to quit.
Saturday night, we all go out.
Right when it counts the most, I injured myself, just felt miserable, so I just decided just to drink the night away.
Ooh. No. Wait, Scott wet his pants.
All the laughs stopped when we saw Scott starting shaking.
EMTs came, and stuck an IV in Scott and tried to revive him. So it really got kind of serious, and jokes were kind of over then.
I think today is the biggest learning experience I've ever had. You know, being in a hospital, being all tubed up and everything is really scary for me. And so I've made a decision that, you know what, I'm just not going to drink anymore.
How you doing, man?
Good.
How you feeling?
Good.
Talk to me about your wrist.
The doctor recommends me putting this on at all times, but I'd rather just take it off, honestly.
I don't want them to point out, you know, that my hand is holding me back.
I'm just gonna come back. You know, if I have to amputate it, so be it. I'm not gonna quit no matter what.
I reversed Scott, and I picked him up, slammed him down on the mat, probably a little bit too hard, because he was knocked out cold.
Come on.
You all right?
Okay.
Yeah.
You all right?
Yeah.
Knock you silly?
Yeah.
Let's have one day where Scott doesn't go to the hospital.
Scott, I think, has come a long way, and I really think he's starting to let his personality show through, which is a good thing.
That's my finishing move, the Drunken Tiger Punch.
What's that?
The Drunken Tiger Punch. Stop! Why did you hit me?
I haven't learned to punch it right.
No kidding!
When I do that, you have to be like...
In the truest sense, this is a competition. And with that in mind, we're going to make a cut tomorrow.
At that moment, I honestly felt like this is it. I'm gone.
I'll walk down the line, I'll stop in front of you, and I will either tell you to sit down, or I will tell you you're cut.
I'm sorry, Chad. You don't have what it takes to be a WWE superstar. You're cut.
Sit down.
Scott's
personality obviously impressed the trainers enough because he survived another week. The car salesman, on the other hand, did not.
Yeah, the first male to get cut was Chad. So now Henry Mann and their struggle to become coming up continues this Thursday. 10 o'clock, 9 central right here on MTV. We'll put more of the show on the way tonight. Spike D'Lo. Hey, Lita, we're coming right back.
Yeah, I know.
CD collection featuring the greatest hits past and present of your favorite WWE superstar entrance and event themes. 86 songs, 38 unreleased tracks, over 3 hours of music on three CDs. WWE Anthology.
I got long sad burns and my hair slick back. I'm coming to
the Survivor Series is approaching, but the battles begin on an historic Super Tuesday. A blockbuster 10-man tag team match, a deadly triple threat, and an unprecedented Raw and SmackDown showdown. Who will survive WWE Super Tuesday? This Tuesday on UPN.
You know, I heard that bikini match is going to take up the entire hour.
Well, I heard we've also got a 10-man tag.
Oh, well, there's that too, but...
From Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 230 pounds, Stephen Richards.
Well, Stephen Richards with that look in his eye. Ready to go.
From Boston, Massachusetts, weighing 226 pounds, Aaron Stevens.
Well, Stephen Richards had to go one-on-one with Aaron Stevens. And folks, as always, tonight Heat is brought to you by Sony Pictures, Half Past Dead in theaters. This coming Friday.
And by Coach Twix. It's all in the mix.
Oh, and by the new Castro GTX. Hi, Miley.
I know.
Well, you know, when we talk about Super Tuesday, this Tuesday night, 9 o'clock, 8 central on UPN. As you mentioned, the huge 10-man tag match from Raw, the triple threat match from SmackDown, the Bikini Challenge, interpromotional Trish against Tori. But one thing I'm particularly...
Oh, now you're trying to say it nonchalant.
No, you know, I'm excited about it, but I'm excited about the whole hour, too. But I want to hear what Shawn Michaels has to say concerning his return to the ring for the first time since SummerSlam, since that huge attack by Triple H.
I think he'd be a little bit mad, just slightly aggravated. I mean, he was in a wheelchair for some time.
Well, if what we've seen the last couple of weeks, 2 weeks ago on Raw and this past Monday night on Raw, is any indication, Shawn Michaels is physically ready to go, and I think mentally ready to go.
Has some mind games of his own for Triple H.
Well, all this past Monday night, Shawn Michaels was playing mind games with Triple H. We're going to take everybody back to the main event a little bit later on from Raw this past week. But now Stephen Richards in a battle with this young Aaron Stevens. And from what I've been told, Aaron Stevens is a very cocky young man. Thinks he's a little bit better than he is, but at least for right now, he's showing me something. I don't know if he has enough to take out Stephen Richards, but we'll see.
He might have enough to trigger the intensity, which we've already seen each and every week from Stephen Richards. So.
And you know, it's funny you should mention triggering intensity, because I saw some big-time intensity from a return from Maven this past Monday night. Maven's been out for 4 or 5 months. Oh, nice drop kick by Aaron Stevens. Here's a cover. Hook the leg. 1-2. And, of course, Christopher Nowinski was back in the town he went to college in, Boston. And out of nowhere, Al Snow brings out Maven, and Maven takes it out on Nowinski.
Nowinski had been asking for it for several weeks.
Exactly. And it's funny you should mention asking for it, because this week, I mentioned, it's a huge week in the WWE. It's WWE week on the hit show Blind Date.
And what would they be asking for?
Well, you draw your own conclusions. But tomorrow on Blind Date, check your local listings. Mr. Hollywood himself will get a chance at a Blind Date.
Oh, right in the shot face.
Funny I should mention Kisser, because tomorrow Nowinski has a blind date on Blind Date. How will he fare? Well, he never asked me for any pointers, so I'm assuming not good. And this coming Friday, Maven will have his opportunity at a blind date also, so it should be interesting all week long as we check out our WWE superstars.
Johnny
on
Stamboli?
Blind date.
No Johnny Stamboli.
They never called Stamboli. You know, They called me. It just didn't happen to work into my schedule.
Scheduling conflict.
Maybe next time. All right, now Steven Richards taking out all of his frustrations on young Aaron Stevens here.
Not looking quite so
cocky is from what I've been told. But maybe it's just a rumor.
You said it, not me. That's why I'm just going to let you continue on.
Exactly right. Well, you know, I mentioned Maven, and it's safe to assume, Lita, that Maven is part of that huge blockbuster trade for the Big Show a few weeks back. But also, Ivory now is a part of Brawl and had a huge match with Trish.
Who for once actually looked more sane of the two women, as we saw Victoria and Ivory together.
You know, I am fully anticipating...
Or possibly teaming up. I mean, Ivory seriously came across more sane than Victoria did.
Yeah, and everybody knows the mouth Ivory's got on her. We see her on Tough Enough 3 each and every week. Never shuts up. And now Aaron Stevens, absolutely telegraphing that. Nobody home. Steven Richards easily out of the way. And now back up to his feet. But, of course, next Sunday's Survivor Series, a huge hardcore rules match. Women's title is on the line. Trish and Victoria and these two women. These issues apparently go way, way back. Or do they?
Well, I think Victoria's issues with Trish go way back. Does Trish care?
Yeah, well, Victoria...
Now Trish definitely cares. But
she cares now, yeah. And it should be a brutal matchup. Victoria,
if I got beamed in the chest with a water bottle, I would start to care.
And Victoria's proven the past few weeks, Lita, that she's very physical.
And she ain't giving up easy.
No, she's not. And the women's title on the line next Sunday. Survivor Series live on pay-per-view. And, of course, we'll be live right here on Sunday Night Heat 7, 6 Central, from the site of Survivor Series, Madison Square Garden. And the event, of course, is sold out. And now Aaron Stevens making somewhat of a comeback on Steven Richards. And I really think, Lita, that Steven Richards is getting a little bit more than even he bargained for here tonight.
Yeah, don't count him out. He's definitely the veteran, and he's going to prove his...
Oh! Nice swinging neck break. Couldn't this be enough? What a huge upset this would be, but no. Steven Richards is able to kick out.
We haven't seen... to look forward to. We haven't seen the rat trap. We haven't seen the... he's talking about it. Some new maneuvers.
Well, he better pull him out in a hurry, or else he's going to lose this matchup. And that won't sit well. Wow, nice shot to the face. One, two, and again, Steven Richards, just before the count of three, is able to kick out. And I think referee Jack Doan just nearly counted out Steven Richards right there. But now Steven Richards, a reversal into the corner. Aaron Stevens up, over, and down. And right now, Steven Richards does not know if he's coming or going. And now nobody home as Steven Richards slides out of the way. Uh-oh. Well, he's
did you hear that? DVT!
Well, there it is, a very unorthodox DVT. But nevertheless,
here is your
effective
winner, Steven Richards.
The leader, Steven Richards, picked up a quality win, and now apparently
letting Aaron know it, in case he didn't know.
Well, we're finding that out right now. Well, coming up next on Heat, four of the six superstars involved in the Elimination Chamber match faced off in the main event on Raw. We'll have the culmination of that colossal tag team matchup when Heat returns, and all is next.
Feel the attitude. Feel the intensity. Nothing beats World Wrestling Entertainment live. Tomorrow night, Cincinnati hosts Raw. Saturday, we make our way to Reading. 1 week from tonight, it's Survivor Series in New York City. And 1 week from tomorrow, it's Raw in Bridgeport. There's nothing like World Wrestling Entertainment live. A legend in the making. A legend already made. Newfound Glory, live at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Presented by AT&T Wireless. Rock's new school at the old school. Look for more concerts with Puddle of Mud, Our Lady Peace, The Wallflowers, and more. Newfound Glory takes over Wednesday at 8.
Yes. Dr. Muto is here. Ingenious morphs, disturbing characters, weird gadgets, and far-off worlds. Rated teen.
Oh, yeah!
On a mountain vacation, six friends have discovered a terrorist plot.
Just kill them.
Keep going, I'll be right behind you!
Now, they have 24 hours to warn the world.
I'm not leaving until they are dead.
Before the unthinkable becomes reality. On November 27th.
Okay, these
We fight back. Extreme Ops, rated PG-13, starts Wednesday, November 27th.
Get into the game with Ratchet and Clank for PlayStation 2, available now at Target. This game rated T for teens.
Sometimes I feel like I'm trapped.
What does your phone say about you?
Check out the world's sexiest undercover women.
I've got something that'll make you smile.
They heat up the action.
I get tired of this part.
They turn on the adventure.
Because it's always better to give than to receive. Whoops.
And the best part? They look hot doing it.
This is vaguely erotic.
If looks could kill, these spies would be deadly.
Ooh, you like that?
Natasha Henstridge in She Spies. Check your local listings. Get primed, November 18th.
WWE Boot of the Week, brought to you by Lugs. Get ready to take over the streets and break it down Lug style. Smooth moves, sleek new shoes, all with Lug's attitude. The streets are ours. Lugs.
What are you doing, Victoria?
Hey!
Oh! Victoria slapping the king! And now look at this mad woman. This is a crazy female.
Well, she's nuts!
This woman is evil. Can you imagine what Victoria can do in a hardcore match at Survivor Series?
Welcome back to Sunday Night Heat, everybody. You know, Lita, we've been talking about it throughout the hour. With Survivor Series only 1 week away, Triple H really starting to feel the pressure.
Absolutely, Coach. Triple H is going to have to defend his World Heavyweight title in some unfamiliar territory.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And this past Monday night, speaking of Triple H, Triple H teamed up with Chris Jericho to take on Kane and Booker T, which proved to be a very heartbreaking main event.
Booker T wants to build some momentum going into the Survivor Series. Saves of Jack Briscoe. The reversal out of the corner and a near fall by Booker T, who strikes suddenly and quickly, a burst on the game, and now on Jericho.
Don't get up there, Nate. Don't get in his way.
And Booker T and Boston to fight. And now Ric Flair up on the apron, and down goes Flair. Beautiful kick by Booker T.
Now goes Triple H. Now what's this sucker going to do?
Right now, Booker T owns the game in Jericho, and he feels the king.
And see it! It's the Spinneroonie in D-Town!
He could be the next World's Heavyweight Champion, and Booker T again, taking down both Jericho
don't get up there
and Flair in the game. Has Booker T ever looked hotter than he's looking to be out here?
Stopping.
The scissors kick. This baby ought to be over. The hook of the leg. There's the count. It is going to be out in Jericho. Coming from outside.
That was so close.
Interrupting the count as referee was headed down for three.
Balls of Jericho coming up. He got it locked in.
Uh-oh, there are a couple balls. And here comes Kane right off the top. Kane knocking Jericho to the outside. I swear, I think it's Booker T and Triple H, the legal men.
Come on, ref, get that Kane.
Toe hold.
Never mind, you don't have to put him back in this corner.
Kane's face bounced off the steel steps.
He's just got to put this
toe hold. And then with the referee off the apron. Booker T with a straight thrust kick, this time right to the jaw of Triple H. And now Booker T has a chance to live his dream at the Survivor Series. Oh, going up top.
They're looking bleak.
Triple H able to dodge that kick. Triple H able to sidestep that kick of Booker T. And now the game looking to execute the pedigree. He's looking for the pedigree. Booker T's trying to fight. Wait a minute.
Look out.
A shot. Oh, Shawn Michaels. Sweet Tim music. Right to the face of the world's heavyweight champion.
Look at that referee right in front of you. Look.
I don't think the referee saw it.
Well, you don't think the referee saw it? My God.
Booker T's going to cover the game.
Wait a minute!
Booker T is
It's great to see you again. Good night.
Good night.
Wait a minute. I've got a question to answer, don't I? Last week, Eric Bischoff invited me to be a part of Survivor Series, to be a part of the Elimination Chamber match, to have a chance at the World Heavyweight Championship. Decisions, decisions, decisions. Let's see. HBK, Survivor Series, first ever Elimination Chamber match, main event, Madison Square Garden for the World Heavyweight Championship. My goodness. Well, the answer is yes.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Wait a minute.
And Triple H, just so you understand, it's been 4 years since HBK has been in Madison Square Garden. I can assure you, I'm walking out of the garden, walking out of that chamber match, the new World Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, Shawn Michaels declaring that he will win the World Heavyweight Championship at Survivor Series. And remember this, Lita. Shawn Michaels seems to accomplish everything he sets his mind to.
That's right, Coach. The Heartbreak Kid has vowed to be on hand for Raw tomorrow night, no doubt, continuing his stalking of Triple H.
And speaking of the game, the World Heavyweight Champion will be in action tomorrow night, going head-to-head with Booker T. It's sure to be an explosive night on Raw, live tomorrow, 9 o'clock, 8 central, on the new TNN.
And the explosions will continue 1 week from tonight in the Elimination Chamber at Survivor Series. The World Heavyweight title will be on the line.
That's exactly right, when Triple H defends that title against Shawn Michaels, Kane, RVD, Chris Jericho, and Booker T. And what promises to be the most dangerous structure ever created. Only the strongest will survive at Survivor Series, live next Sunday, only on pay-per-view.
Coming up next on Heat, Spike Dudley takes on D'Lo Brown, and we are coming right back.
An object of terror. A vision of horror. Six will battle for the World Heavyweight Championship. Triple H, Booker T, Rob Van Dam, Kane, Jericho, and the return of Shawn Michaels. The Elimination Chamber is here. The nightmare is about to begin.
Raw and SmackDown present WWE Survivor Series, brought to you by Xbox, live next Sunday on pay-per-view.
Thursday at 10, not all moves go down in the ring.
I really have a crush on John, and it's not going away.
And another one gets the axe.
Somebody's about to lose their dream.
You're getting slammed with MTV's WWE Heat thanks to Burger King. Say hello to the new 99 cents BK value menu. And Sega.
Rated M for mature.
Where is he?
Shinobi's back!
Sega!
Oh, I don't know how to make anything fancy.
Make something homie style.
Hey. Ooh, cheese, beef, more cheese, bacon, three more strips. I declare this Extreme Burger the winner.
Omar, you've created a Whopper.
For a limited time, get the new Extreme Bacon and Cheese Whopper. Juicy flame-broiled beef, two kinds of cheese, four strips of bacon. You gotta have the Extreme Bacon and Cheese Whopper at Burger King now.
Woohoo! Carry me home! Go!
Just Greg.
Just
Jessica Spencer. She had it all until a curse put her into his body. Now, she's realizing how good she had it.
It's me, Jessica!
And how bad she wants it back.
I should have made love to you when I had the chance.
Who was that?
I think it was my old camp counselor.
The Hot Chick.
Hey, Millie!
Rated PG-13. See it December 13th.
Tomorrow on Animal Crossing for Nintendo GameCube.
Nice outfit. Where'd you get it? A garbage dump?
Yeah.
Welcome to Animal Crossing, the live game that's happening every minute of every day, whether you're playing or not. Rated everyone.
The road of life can be bumpy, and sometimes bad things happen to good people. If you have credit concerns and are having problems buying a car, please come see us at Finley Ford Lincoln Mercury. We can help. I invite you to call our toll-free credit hotline regardless of your credit history. It's fast, it's easy, and it's confidential. We sincerely want to help you smooth out the bumps and get back on the road to financial responsibility. Call us today, because at Finley Ford Lincoln Mercury, we care about you.
If you call this number, you'll also get this bonus DVD of behind-the-scenes footage and interviews free with your paid CD order. Now or Never, the debut solo album from Nick Carter. To order, call the number on your screen to get your copy of Nick Carter's debut album, Now or Never. You will also get this bonus behind-the-scenes DVD free with your paid CD order. Must be 18 or older to call.
Thursday at 10:30.
Yeah. Barter College is in serious trouble. Applications are down 73%. Graduates cannot read above a fifth grade level.
I don't think your statistics reflect the quality of student on this campus.
What the hell is that?
I don't know.
Kill it!
And now, the extreme blast of the night, rocked by JVC's Tower of Power. With 460 watts of mind-numbing sound, dual 8 inch subs, and MP3 playback to keep the party rocking all night long. The Tower of Power by JVC, the only system big enough to crush the competition.
Batista making his in-ring debut here on Raw. Oh, what a monster. What an athlete this Batista is. Look at this power sting and a set-down power bomb. Set-down power bomb. And boy, this one is emphatically over. Batista.
JVC's Tower of Power.
Lee, I tell you what, Batista is huge. Very impressive debut on Raw.
Emphatically over, I would have to say myself.
Oh, gosh, he's an animal.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, weighing 150 pounds, Spike Dudley.
There goes Spike Dudley, set to take on D'Lo Brown. And
speaking of Spike,
yeah, he's fired up, but still a little bit dinged up. He's got those ribs taped from a few weeks ago, that heinous attack by 3 minute warning. But folks, Xbox presents WWE Survivor Series. This holiday season, there is no power greater than X. Check it out at Xbox.com. And Survivor Series comes to you live next Sunday from the sold-out Madison Square Garden in New York City. Saying earlier, so we need to welcome to the show right now, Milan. Milan, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. It's very nice to be here.
Milan, we have some questions. We weren't quite sure what this masterpiece was about.
Well, as I was talking to D'Lo earlier, D'Lo has no clue what it is. Spike Dudley has no clue what it is. And actually, nobody in the world knows what this masterpiece is really all about. I don't either. So all I can tell you is that Raven doesn't know what he's talking about, and neither does anybody else. That's all I have to say. Now I have to go back because D'Lo, my good friend, and your good friend, and Coach, your old partner, and Lita, your good friend, is ready to take on Spike Dudley.
But that's it. Excuse me, Coach. Milan, what did you interpret then?
I interpreted nothing because there was nothing to interpret.
Well, here we go. Thank you very much, Milan. We'll see you later. D'Lo set to go one-on-one with Spike Dudley, of course. We want to thank Milan for stopping by, but now we've got to concentrate on D'Lo and Spike. And as I mentioned, Spike's still kind of reeling from the attack that he suffered at the hands of 3 Minute Warning a few weeks ago.
Spike never seems to get a break. I don't think he ever goes into a match healthy because he's just always getting knocked around.
Well, of course, 3 Minute Warning, Rosie, Jamal, and Rico certainly made their mark, made their their impact ever since Eric Bischoff read them the riot act a couple of weeks ago.
Are they out of the doghouse yet, you
well,
think?
I think they're maybe halfway out of the doghouse, not completely out yet.
Maybe
but
hanging
they're
out with
getting
some
there.
Of the dogs from the D'Lo Nation in there. While they're...
the dogs from the D'Lo Nation! Oh, you know, I am so fired up this week, and I don't know why. Maybe it's because this is possibly, you know, this is probably the second biggest week we've had this year. You know, with the exception of WrestleMania, so many things are happening this week in the WWE. I don't even know where to start. I said by Spike and D'Lo being
he's
a little conscious.
Feeling each other out a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, I think he just gave me a little shoulder shaking. You know what I'm saying? And now a nice little...
It's all good. That's
yeah, a nice little touch there. A little... Oh, and now apparently the crowd
we
didn't appreciate
that. We call that a handshake,
that. Well, I know what it is. But, you know, but, you know, where do we start? Do we start with Blind Date? Do we start with Super Tuesday?
The
anthology. The Elimination Chamber. I mean, of course, this Tuesday anthology.
There's
WWE
also some other stuff going on, too, Coach.
I know there's a lot of things, and I know it's hard to keep track. And, of course, this
Thursday.
You know
who else could show up, maybe?
Who?
Scott Steiner.
You know, Big Papa Pump could show up. How much coffee have you had today, by the way? You've had a lot of coffee. I don't think we've ever seen you like this before.
I just hear him.
I know. You know, this whole holler if you hear me thing, I'm going to
yeah,
I'll
probably get old pretty quick. Well, don't worry. I'll get it out of my system.
Oh, my goodness. What elevation. And I think that's going to get old pretty quick.
Spike sucking wind right now. All wind taken right out.
Wow. So, yeah, Big Papa Pump could show up at any time. We still don't know at this point if Scott Steiner is going to head for Raw. Oh, look at D'Lo nailing
those. That wasn't nice at all.
You know, whatever happened to that handshake that we saw a few moments ago? Why would D'Lo
out the
go?
Window.
Well, apparently so.
For now. Maybe at the end of the match.
And now both men on the outside, and D'Lo, drops Spike right on the ring barrier. And Spike certainly feeling the effects.
D'Lo figures, hey, I got 10 seconds out here. I might as well use them.
Use all 10. Use all 10. Folks, don't forget this Tuesday. Get out and get your copy of WWE Anthology on sale this Tuesday. Oh! They're shaking! It dropped straight down on Spike, but no cover. Apparently, D'Lo wants a little bit more. Not ready to go home as of yet. Well, now Spike into the corner, and D'Lo, right into that boot. Maybe waiting a little bit too long, but now Spike catches him with a nice head scissors, and D'Lo is reeling.
I think it made him mad.
All 150 pounds of Spike is a little teed off. And that handshake is long since been
forgotten. You want to stop? Can he even answer?
Well, all the wind that Spike did have is no longer.
Get the back, and it's gone again.
You know, Lita, before we get out of here tonight, of course, right to the midsection again. We need to set the table. Here's a cover, 1-2, and a kick out by Spike. For next Sunday, of course, we're going to be live, 7-6 Central, right here on MTV. From Madison Square Garden for Survivor Series, but your thoughts on the Elimination Chamber match?
Well, since, you know, I've already known about this Elimination Chamber, inside sources.
Well, you got the inside scoop.
But I'm still completely excited to see it. Never been done before. And it's always exciting to see something that's never been done. So many guys fighting for one common goal.
That being the World Heavyweight Championship.
Yes, indeed.
Well, now, D'Lo's working those ribs again with the bear hug, and Spike nails the ears of D'Lo getting out of that. Oh, but right back into the kick and going for the headbutt and getting
Spike
caught right
in
the head. Well, now both men attempting to get back to their feet. And folks, next Sunday, the Elimination Chamber match. Oh, and now Spike does connect with the battering ram. And now a big, big elbow to the face of D'Lo Brown. And don't forget, of course, the WWE Championship on the line, Brock Lesnar and The Big Show from SmackDown. And, of course, Trish and Victoria, hardcore rules for the women's title. And now D'Lo nails Spike, but why is D'Lo not covering?
I don't know.
Why would D'Lo not jump on top of Spike right now? Maybe he wants to deliver more punishment. And now you can see the look. I haven't seen this type of look on D'Lo's face in a long, long time. And now going for the sky high, but Spike is able to reverse it. 1-2, and oh, he gets the victory.
Spike able to get the victory.
Spike able to reverse like D'Lo had the upper hand with the sky high. And apparently D'Lo not too happy about things as Spike's still reeling from those injured ribs. What is D'Lo going to do? D, don't do this. Whatever you're going to do, don't do it.
Jeez, D'Lo. You have to do that a little bit
of love. Oh, well, a little bit of love there. I like that. Well, folks, don't forget, tomorrow night, Raw will be live from Cincinnati.
That's right. Shawn Michaels is about to be on Raw live tomorrow night. And it looks as though HBK is docking. The Triple H is going to continue.
Yeah, also on Raw tomorrow, the World Heavyweight Champion Triple H goes head-to-head with Booker T in a preview of Survivor Series.
And the World Tag Team Championships will be on the line tomorrow night when Chris Jericho and Christian defend the titles against Rob Van Dam and Kane.
It should be a special, special night tomorrow live from Cincinnati. And don't forget about Super Tuesday, this
Tuesday
night on UPN 9 o'clock, 8 central. For Lita, I'm the coach. We'll see you tomorrow night.